You should have a thermometer separate from the thermometer that is in built in into the refrigerator. So you should have a refrigerator thermometer as well as a freezer thermometer. Your refrigerator thermometer should be set at 41 degrees or lower, and your freezer should be at 0 degrees or lower. Don't always depend on the dials that are in there because those could be inaccurate. The fuller the freezer, the longer the temperature will last. So if the freezer is about half full, you can get bags of ice, just plain ice, and you want to put those in there and put them, if you can, at the top. If it's an upright freezer, put it at the top. Put trays underneath to catch any water that might melt because the cold air will go down. And as long as it's solidly frozen, it will help maintain the temperature. If you have a chest type freezer, those will help maintain temperature better. Because again, the cold air will be lower, it won't be coming out. You always want the more contaminated products, which would be your raw products, raw meats, on the lower shelves. And you also want to make, maybe even have them, make sure they're in bags or containers that can hold juices once it does thaw. To be prepared, it is better to try to have non-perishables. Make sure you also have a can opener if you have canned goods. With dry goods, try to put them in some type of airtight container and make sure that they are above any flood waters if that should happen. If your power is out, keep the refrigerator and freezer doors closed. Don't go, because you know how a lot of people will stand looking? You don't want to do that. Keep the doors closed. The general rule of thumb is that the food will stay frozen a day or two, depending again on how full your freezer is. With refrigerator temperatures, you're only talking a couple of hours. If bad weather is coming and you've been prepared, hopefully you could have gotten a generator. That generator can also help maintain the temperature of that refrigerator freezer, but again, keep the doors closed. If you do have a power outage and you have grills, you can cook on those, but make sure they are in a ventilated area. You do not want to operate gas grills, charcoal grills, anything inside of a house or carport or anything like that. You want to make sure it's well ventilated.